Everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video, guys, I'm going to show you from ARCCAPTAIN. This is new pro serial MIG205MP with advanced technology, perfect function and high performance. Pretty cool design, big wide display, lots of functions here, and I'm going to show you later more in detail. I'm going to try out some welding. Also, you can use your remote control via mobile app in this package. We got lots of goodies here with this welding machine. Should be a MIG welding torch, up to 10 feet of cables, some torch accessories, conduct tips, nozzle, diffuser, ground clamp, elector holder, lift TIG gun, cut gun or plasma gun, gas regulator, gas hose, spool gun, protection cover, rollers, and operator's manual. It's a pretty good quality. Special design for this machine, well, so you can use those adapters to hook your own welding cables like you can do in a previous series of ARCCAPTAIN machines. As I said, lots of accessories. It's pretty impressive so far. MIG torch, TIG gun. So we're just gonna try it out, and a cover. I like this. This is actually really handy, especially when a dusty environment. As I said, pretty wide display. It's like a rolling knobs that you can actually surf through your menu, what you got over there, and then just press push to confirm. Gas regulator. It got two inputs on the back side for your gas and for your air. And you can do 110 or 220. So we're just gonna go with a 220. Okay, so when you turn it on, it's a pretty wide display with actually voice prompt equipped with voice prompts like for polarity, wiring protection, warning, and other functions for each welding mod. This place is pretty cool. Got operation mode selection area, as you can see, and a pulse function switch area, parameter selection area, and welding mode selection area. So you can go and do some fine tuning. There's also sync with already preset. Depends on the wire size and everything, so it'll give you preset already settings, or you can do by yourself, do it manually. We're just gonna try out with the TIG first. For TIG, there's a lift TIG mode or high frequency TIG mode. Just gonna use the parts what they provided me. I really like to stick with my cup size 8. As I said, this is the ARCCAPTAIN app. It's a remote through your mobile app where you can set up all the parameters. Depends on the welding mode you're using, from your pre-flow, post-flow, depends from operation. There's actually really pictures on the underneath, then you can go through what you depends from the welding mode you're using. You can set up the amps. It connects to Bluetooth. It's pretty cool, actually, features. This is first time I'm using something like this. As you can see, on the display on a welding machine, how it changes. So you can change manually on the machine while you're using app. So we're just gonna go through the app, do some parameters, do some fine tuning, and see how it works. It's a pretty cool feature. I mean, for ARCCAPTAIN, for this welding machine, lots of functions, lots of welding mods. Like technology-wise, it's pretty impressive for the affordable price that you can actually buy. Just Just gonna run 110 amps on this piece of stainless material. Yeah, using a 316 filler wire. This is pretty good looking weld bead, pretty nice and smooth, melts really nice. Now we're gonna switch to stick. So let's see what the stick mode looks like. Just gonna set up here. I'm probably around 130 amps, 129 for 1/8 7/18 rod. I got a piece of metal here. Just gonna run one straight bead. Initial start, it's pretty good actually, and it melts really nice. I'm just gonna chip off that slag and show you how the weld looks like. This is pretty good looking weld bit for stick. Nothing's wrong with that. You can do any job, any for any hobbyist or even some light professional job if you got. Now we're gonna switch to cutting torch. We're gonna hook up the air connection here. This machine is already equipped with a air pressure gauge and also filter to collect any vapor oil from then you can actually drain. You can just pull upward to set up your PSI. Minimum working PSI should be around 75 PSI. We are around 50 amps for this. And I'm just gonna cut on a piece of angle iron here. And it's cutting pretty cool. Nice and smooth, like through the butter. So far, pretty impressive actually. My buddy, he's running a, he's a usually Miller guy. I mean, like any professional person, but he's actually really impressed with his welding machine, same as me. We can actually play with it. Nice, good, clean cut. Apparently it can go up to 1/2 inch. I didn't have any 1/2 inch material to cut. And the other good thing about plasma, it's perfect for aluminum. If you guys work with aluminum, like for plasma cutting, aluminum is excellent. No aluminum dust all over the place. So if you need to cut, this cutting torch is perfect for your any aluminum job. Yeah, this is pretty cool. Nice clean cut. Okay, now we're gonna switch. Now I'm gonna switch to MIG. I'm gonna set up the wire spool inside, connect this 70S6. You gotta fit through the rollers, depends from your wire size. This is a 0.35. Set up speed adjustment wire speed, and then we're gonna run to the one piece. And of course, you connect. It says for MIG. This is where CO2 or mix. I'm using the mixture of gases, argon and CO2. The good thing, you already got the, like on the side panel of the door. You got a table that you can. Refer to whatever you're using. It really helpful, helps you out with the settings. You can also set up here for your gas flow, for your settings, for your wire speed, voltage. You can also sync. You can use that through your mobile app, as I shown before. I'm just gonna run a couple beats here, try to do some vertical and some horizontal. It's pretty good actually, lots of function. This is, I really like this about this welding machine. It really runs really nice, even on 110. Oh, by the way, this is on 110. The previous, the plasma cutting and TIG was on 220. Yeah, absolutely nothing's wrong with that. I mean, for any for any hobby or any work you got, any small project, this is absolutely good. I mean, for the price that you can buy on the market, this machine pretty much covers it all. You got everything. Just gonna run a couple more beats here. Just doing fine tuning, playing with the settings. Yeah, you can see the difference. Running hot, there's no undercut on the top, really melts perfect with the base material. Okay, now I'm gonna switch to spool gun. I'm gonna put some aluminum spool wiring inside. Goes right on the top. You feed that through that rollers, that tight knob. I actually never used aluminum spool gun before. All I did was just TIG aluminum. Okay, same thing with the settings. I already got some preset or sync parameters. That's actually factory saved inside a welding machine. I just got this aluminum piece here. Hold your gun at a 45 degree angle to the workpiece with nozzle about 1/2 inch from the surface, and just move the gun smoothly and steadily as you weld on this aluminum workpiece. Yeah, that's not too bad. As I said, just turn the knob to find the required voltage. Just play with the settings. You can refer to your table on a door panel inside. So I'm just gonna stick to that recommendation as a starting point, and you can always, as I said, adjust as you need, as you want. On a TIG gauge material, I just move a little bit quickly. I only weld maybe 1/4 inch stitch welds at a time to avoid melt through, or you can also got spotter. You can see here right on the gun itself on a torch that you can adjust your wire speed. This is actually pretty good, cool feature. And that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. As I said, pretty impressed what this machine can do for the budget. There's gonna be a link and a promo code for you guys down in the description. And before I go, don't forget to check out ARCCAPTAIN's website. The Christmas bundle is live right now, and they always have some good solid deals on welding machines, equipment, all accessorized, especially this time of the year, so it's worth checking out. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one, guys. Take care.